guys, we stayed there for 2 days, did 2 nights of investigation, and we got there. A guy who was in his room said, every time he came out and went back up to his room, he left the being disturbed on the outside. And he'd come back, and it was on a chair on the other side of the corridor. So we assumed the maid would come around and for some reason taken it off, so we keep going back and putting it on, and it happened consistently. So we got to the point where we started to think, we checked with the staff and said, no one's doing this. We thought, okay, this must be potentially paranormal. So we'll the camera off for the duration, about 2 hours of tape, kept it running, put the do a stop sign on his doorknob, then went away, locked the room, or locked the corridor off so no one could go in, and put the motion sensors down so we would know if anyone did. And I went back about 2 hours later, turned the sensors off, went up, it was still on the doorknob, so turned the camera off, took the tripod down, went back out, and he came following us to find out what happened. We went past him, literally saw the doors there, went past him here. He said, so did it happen? No, I didn't get anything. So I've taken it all down. He said, oh no, typical, isn't it? And he walked past me down, goes to his room, and then he said, oi, did you leave it on the door or on the chair? I said, it was on the door. He said, no, it's not, it's on the chair. And literally within 10 seconds of me picking the camera up and walking away, the thing had gone from the door onto the chair. But the only time I didn't have a camera, yeah. I was just like, it's a common occurrence, and you just start to wonder. It's almost as if there's some written rule that you can't get evidence.
Yeah.
And people say, well, it can't be true because you haven't, where's the proof?